Are you excited? Much better. Thank you very much. Okay, so without further ado, I'd like to introduce to you Karina and Alexa. They're going to be performing as a little girl and her doll, and the performance is called Dollhouse by Melanie Martinez.
I'm sorry, honey, that your mother couldn't make it to your birthday, but here is a doll from her to you. Her name is Mimi. Please take care of it.
Oh, she's beautiful. She looks just like Mom. I hate it. How does it feel, Mom? How does it feel being hit? How does it feel not being perfect? Jesus Christ.
Hey girl, open the walls, play with your dolls. We'll be a perfect family. When you walk away is when we really play. You don't hear me when I say, Mom, please wake up. Dad's with a tramp and your son is smoking cannabis. No one ever listens, this wallpaper glistens. Don't let them see what goes down in the kitchen. Places, places, get in your places. Throw on your dress and put on your doll faces. Everyone thinks that we're perfect. Please don't let them look through the curtain. Picture, picture, smile for the picture. Pose with your brother, won't you be a good sister? Everyone thinks that we're perfect. Please don't let them look through the curtain. D-O-L-L-H-O-U-S-E. I see things that nobody else sees. D-O-L-L-H-O-U-S-E. I see things that nobody else.
Hey girl, look at my mom. She's got it going on. Ha! You're blinded by her jewelry. When you turn your back, she pulls out a flask and forgets his infidelity. Uh-oh, she's coming to the attic. Plastic, go back to being plastic. No one ever listens, this wallpaper glistens. One day they'll see what goes down in the kitchen.
Places, places, get in your places. Throw on your dress and put on your doll faces. Everyone thinks that we're perfect. Please don't let them look through the curtain. Picture, picture, smile for the picture. Pose with your brother, won't you be a good sister? Everyone thinks that we're perfect. Please don't let them look through the curtain. D-O-L-L-H-O-U-S-E. I see things that nobody else sees. D-O-L-L-H-O-U-S-E. I see things that nobody else sees.
Thank you.
We have a performance of the song Secrets by Catherine Maxwell as Junko Inoshima from, you know, I'm going to try this one, Danganronpa. Give it up for Catherine.
Got a secret, can you keep it? Swear this one you'll save. Better lock it in your pocket, taking this one to the grave. If I show you, then I know you won't tell what I said. Cause two can keep a secret if one of them is dead. Why do you smile like you have told a secret? Now you're telling lies cause you have sworn to keep it. No one keeps a secret. No one keeps a secret. Why, when we do our darkest deeds, do we tell? They burn in our brain, become a living hell. Cause everybody tells. Hey.
not a secret, can you keep it? Well, this one you'll say, better lock it in your pocket, taking this one to the grave. If I show you, then I know you won't tell what I said. 'Cause two can keep a secret if one of them is dead.
So next, it's the match of the century in this corner. The Slayer of Men. The master of memes, Hot Topic's most popular superhero, Deadpool. And the other corner, some loser with a bow and arrow. So get ready for Hawkeye versus Deadpool, everyone.
Okay, so I know this looks bad. Knots. I'm good at knots. Okay, got this. Wait, no?
Hey, I'm here. Brought some Young Avenger backup and...
Every time, Clint. Every time.
Not my fault.
I know it's not your fault. It's
me, Deadpool! I'm helping you. You're the weakest Avenger. I knew you need the extra training.
Hey!
Not you, Hawkeye. I was talking to Hawkeye. Anyways, come on. Give us all you got. You got?
Deadpool, idiot! I stabbed you in the stomach!
Tis but a flesh wound. You picked the music last time. Now it's my turn to pick the tunes, bro.
I like big butts and I cannot lie. You other brothers can't deny. That when a girl walks in with an itty bitty waist and a round thing in your face, you get sprung. Wanna pull up tough, 'cause you notice that butt was stuck. Deep in the jeans she's wearing, I'm hooked and I can't stop staring. Oh baby, I wanna get whipped up and take your picture. My homeboy's trying to warn me, but that butt you got me. Ooh, rump of smooth skin, you say you wanna get in my bins? Well, use me, 'cause you ain't that average groupie. I seen her dancing.
Okay, so here are my options. A, quickly duck left, dodge the chair, and take him out with a spinning back kick. Or B, take the chair in the face, roll on the ground, and die. Should've gone with A.
Closer, it's story time. All right. Out of the archives of 1944 comes a Western hero who tamed the likes of fierce outlaws, as well as corrupt politicians. She brought them all to justice with her wits, side iron, and a whip. Ladies and gentlemen, Cindy Morrison brings you Zorro's Black Whip.
Thank you.
Little Mermaid. Of course, it's Disney. It's a classic. But you remember when the Little Mermaid lost her voice to the Sea Witch? Well, even though she traded her voice to the Sea Witch, Ursula, Ariel had a lot going on in her head, and we're about to find out what that was.
Just look, it's like I'm in a storybook. Oh, it's bliss. I dreamed that it would be somewhat, but not like this. Look over there. Oh my God, how very odd, and what might they be? Something splendid, maybe. Look over here. Could you bust? Isn't it just bedazzling? Dazing, utterly amazing. Gazing round, it's like to die. Just seeing it feels so good. I'd scream if I only could. I hope and wished and wanted so to be here. Wished and prayed and planned it to a T. Prayed and wow, just look, it's really me here. Walking around, strange as it seems, somewhere beyond my wildest dreams.
Just keeps on going. Hear how she's not talk. Look at her stare. Lucky man who chose like this to stay for dinner. What does he see in her? Hush now, girl, she's simply shy. Just picture the table chat. One side of the baby.
Pictured what I'd see, prayed, and whoa, my prayers are coming true here. Look at it all, look how it gleams, lovely beyond my wildest dreams. Look, it's him, so handsome and refined and slim, sweet, sincere, magnificent from head to toe. Look at it all, hall after hall, perfect as you could please hear, marvelous galore, and even more, gee, did I mention he's here, and if we're not, all of it goes past you, these extremes, just look at me, and you will see someone beyond her wildest dreams.
Okay, and now, gather around again, everyone, it's story time. Okay, this one's a little bit wordy, let me tell you. Petra Howard accidentally summons Earl Gregg, and Earl Gregg takes advantage of the situation and kidnaps Petra H. to his mansion and forces Petra to play his love games like Lady Gaga. But Petra wants no part in it. This is the adventure of Petra Howard and Earl Gregg.
It was a dark, poopy night when Petra had an encounter with the coolest, most handsome, most admiring, most...
Dude, we get it.
Anyways, she came in contact with Ciel. What in bloody hell are you doing in my manor?
I swear, there's no one here. I'm just, a ghost?
Oh, okay. Wait, are you the ghost of my love? Do you love me?
I got a skedaddle. Where's the exit?
You're not leaving here, fuzzy little ghost peach.
Mother licker. Fine, I propose to you a game.
Games?
Yes, a love game.
Love games?
The dance battle. Whoever wins gets the funk, and I get set. Free.
Okay, but in one condition. We get married tonight in Iwatobi outfits to match a cute couple like Haru and Rin.
Oh Lord Jesus, please save my fuzzy little man butt.
Man?
Ghost?
Oh, okay.
My anaconda don't, my anaconda don't, my anaconda don't want none unless you got buns, hun.
Oh, cocoa. I'm in love with the cocoa. I got it for the lolo.
Okay, you won the first round, but let's see how you do on the second round. It's a whistle off.
Fine, bring it.
Okay, okay, I got it.
Ready? Watch this. Enough said. Or should I say, enough whistle. Ha! I win! We now get married and the funk is all mine!
What? Can't be! How did I lose? I'm actually a human! Ghosts don't exist!
You liar!
There's only one way this can be true. Your Illuminati confirmed.
Come here, funk! Yes, how did you know? Now the whole world would know my real name!
Sumpalki?
No, Esteban Julio Ricardo de la Rosa Montoya.
Prize internally, tear. Okay, this is a bit awkward, but...
You still want to get married? Heck yeah!
You know, okay, but next we have America from Italia singing the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light.
Okay, we need a new national anthem. That's kind of old and boring, and we need something awesome. Something heroic. Because I'm the hero, so...
I'm the hero never backs away. I'm the hero who saves the day, gives you burgers and runs away. England, you can't stop me now, even with your big eyebrows, you can't stop me now. 'Cause I'm the hero never backs away. I'm the hero has come to save the day.
Next, we have Tiffany Amber as Elsa and Caitlin Cortino as Anna from Frozen. Obviously, I'm excited.
You don't have to protect me. I'm not afraid. Please don't shut me out again. Please don't slam the door. You don't have to keep your distance anymore. 'Cause for the first time in forever, I finally understand. For the first time in forever, we can fix this hand in hand. We can head down this mountain together. You don't have to live in fear. 'Cause for the first time in forever, I will be right here.
Anna, please go back home. Your life awaits. Go enjoy the sun and open up the gates.
Yeah, but I know
you mean well, but leave me be. Yes, I'm alone, but I'm alone and free. Just stay away and you'll be safe from me.
Actually, we're not.
What do you mean you're not?
I get the feeling you don't know.
What do I not know?
Arendelle's in deep, 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 deep snow.
What?
You kind of set off an eternal winter everywhere.
Everywhere?
Well, it's okay, you can just unfreeze it.
No, I can't. I don't know how.
Sure you can. I know you can.
'Cause for the first time in forever,
I'm such a fool. I can't
be free. No escape from the storm inside.
Control the curse. We'll reverse this storm.
Oh, please, you'll only make it worse.
Sunshine,
there's so much fear.
Sunshine,
you're not safe here.
We can face this thing together. We can
now we get to be entertained because Jack Frost is having a little trouble letting it go.
The snow glows white on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen. A kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I tried. It's time to see what I can do to test the limits and break through. No right, no wrong, no rules for me. I'm free. Let it go, let it go. Can't hold it back anymore. Let it go, let it go. They'll never see me cry. Here I stand in the light of day.
Ice castle, build an ice castle.
My power flurries through the air into the ground. My soul is spiraling in frozen fractals all around. And one thought crystallizes like an icy blast. I'm never going back. The past is in the past. Let it go, let it go. When I rise like the break of dawn, let it go. Let it go, that perfect girl is gone. Here I stand in the light of day. Let the storm rage on. The cold never bothered me anyway.
So, next, I have to change the tone a little bit, and I need you to cover your ears and hide your children. It's the horrible fan fiction, My Immortal, and it's coming to life right now.
My Immortal, Chapter 3, Author's Note.
Stop flaming the story, preps, okay? Otherwise, thanks to the Gothic people for the good reviews. Thanks again, Raven. On the night of the concert, I put on my black lace-up boots with high heels. Underneath them were ripped red fishnets. I then put on my black leather mini dress with corset stuff on the back and on the front. I put on matching fishnets on my arms. I straightened my hair and made it look all spiky. I felt a little depressed then, so I slit one of my wrists. I read a depressing book, waiting for it to stop bleeding, while I was listening to GC. I then put on, I painted my nails black, and I put on tons of eyeliner. Then I put on some black lipstick, but I didn't put on foundation because I was pale anyway.
Yeah, I'm like...
I drank some human blood, and I was ready to go to the concert. I walked outside. Draco was there, standing in front of his flying car. He was wearing a simple plan t-shirt. They were gonna play at the play anyways. Baggy black skater pants, black nail polish, and a little eyeliner. Authors know. A lot of cute boys wore it, okay? God. Hi, Draco, I said in a depressed voice.
Abner.
He said back. We walked into the flying Mercedes-Benz. The license plate is 666. God. And flew to the place with the concert. On the way, we listened to excitedly to Good Skrillate and Marilyn Manson. We both smoked cigarettes and
drank.
When we got there, we both hopped out of the car. We walked up to the mosh pit in front of the stage and jumped up and down as we listened to Good Skrillate. Joel is so mucky hot, I said, pointing at him as his wonderful voice filled the audience. Suddenly, Draco looked sad. What's wrong? I asked as we moshed to the music. Then I caught on. Hey, It's okay. He isn't better than you.
Really, really?
Asked Draco sensitively as he put his arm around me, all protective. Really, really? I said. Because I don't even know Joel. He's going out with Hillary mucking Duff. I mucking hate that little itch.
Itch.
I said disgustingly, thinking of her ugly blonde face. The night went on really well, and I had a great time.
So did Draco.
After the concert, we drank some beer and asked Benji and Joelle for their autographs and some photos. We got GC concert tees. Draco and I crawled back into the working fence. But we didn't go back to Hogwarts. We went to
the Forbidden Forest. My Immortal, Chapter 4, author's note.
I said Stoop Flamin', okay? Ebony's name is Annabelle.
Not Mary Sue.
Okay? Draco is so in love with her that he is acting different. They knew each other before, okay? Draco! I shouted. What the muck do you think you're doing? Draco didn't answer, but he stopped flying the car and walked out of it. I walked out of it too, curiously. What the monkey L? I asked angrily.
Ebony.
What? I snapped. Then, Draco leaned in extra close and I looked into his gothic red eyes. He was wearing colored contacts. But then suddenly, I saw all of this depressing sorrow and evilness in his eyes, and I didn't feel mad anymore.
Yeah, like...
And then, suddenly, just as I, Draco kissed me back. Draco climbed on top of me and we kissed passionately. He took off my top and I took off his clothes. I even took off my bra. Then he put his thingy in my you-know-what and we did it for the first time.
Wow!
We started to kiss everywhere. And my pale, warm body went all red. And then...
What the hell are you doing, you mother muckers?
It was Dumbledore!
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.
A live-action version will be releasing soon. I'm still not sure what we're going to be calling it, though, but it will be My Immortal live action in
Jeremy
Miami.
By Jeremy McFerrin and Giselle Romero.
See you guys.
Love you all.
Because now I need y'all to remember something for our next performance. You have to really watch these two, and I mean it. Don't blink. Vortex. Here's Noah, the 12th Doctor!
When you think of it, we all change, and that's all right, as long as we remember all the people that we used to be. And I swear I will never forget one line of this, and when the Doctor was me.
So, all the way here from Republic City, please welcome the two avatars. As you all know, these are the only two people who can save the world.
Thank you.
that those were the only two people who could possibly save the world, but the only two people who can save us from the League of Evil, Bikini Bottom's oldest superheroes, are back.
It's the adventures of Merman Man
and
Barnacle Boy. Gosh darn it, Mermaid Man. Where's the invisible boatmobile?
I thought you parked it, Barnacle Boy.
What are you talking about?
Can I get the invisible boatmobile keys?
Okay, one second. Here you go. Beep, beep. It's around here somewhere. It has to be. Well, there it is, I guess. Oh, dear. Did you drop the invisible boatmobile keys? Oh, well. It's almost 3:30. It's time for the early bird special at the Krusty Krab. Come on, let's go.
All right, Barnacle Boy, time to get you a kitty meal.
It's Barnacle Man, I have to say.
All right, Barnacle Man, let's get you a manly meal.
Okay.
Next up, Lyrin looks to take revenge on Junior for a fallen friend. All the way here from Remnant, it's Steven and Gabriel. On this time, please welcome from the year 3000, the Terminator.
It's showtime. Allow me to break the ice. I need your clothes, your boots, and your motorcycle. Give them to me now. You are not you. You are me, right? Wrong. Stop cheering me up. No problemo. It's not a tumor. Not a tumor at all. Put that cookie down now. Go, run, get back to the chopper. I'm in here. Kill me. Come on. Kill me. Kill me now. If it bleeds, we can kill it. Hasta la vista, baby. You are terminated. I'll be back. You are terminated. I need a vacation. But if you're not still not convinced, I'll be back.
I know you. I walked with you once upon a dream. I know you. That look in your eyes is so familiar.
Stand. Rise from Maleficent.
That visions are seldom all they see. But if I know you, I know what you'll do. You'll love me at once, the way you did once upon a dream.
Oh my, what an illustrious gathering we have here tonight. We have the royalty, the gentry, and they even invited the rabble. And yet somehow, I didn't receive my invitation. But let's get the story straight. I was never a fairy. I was a witch, and the best of the baddest of them all. Maleficent means beautiful evil, and it is because of my beautiful evil that princes and princesses and you heroes could shine so brightly. But then again, don't fear the evil. Just realize we are part of your world.
But first I want to introduce you to our excellent judges. First we have Sev9. Yes, she's one of our supergirls of Supercon. I'm sure you've seen her, know her, love her. Absolutely. And we have Canon Cosplay. I mean, that's kind of silent. Okay, yes, yes, woo! Very nice. And Sandy, Sand Muffin Cosplay. And here are our lovely judges, ready to give you the awards.
Alrighty, if you do not know who I am, then I must teach you. My name is Wednesday Adams, and I enjoy everything that is torturous. And my judges' award goes to my immortal. So everybody loves a good comedian, so this skit really made me laugh. So my judge's choice award goes to the Deadpool fight.
Okay, my judge's award is simple. He did a really, really, really good job. It's gonna go to the Terminator.
Okay.
am I doing it? Okay, so the next award is going to be the junior. The junior award goes to Doctor Who and his Weeping Angels. Okay, best individual. It actually really takes a lot of skill doing this. And so we chose the whip. The black whip, was it? I think it was the black whip. Zorro's black whip. I don't know if you guys tried cracking a whip, but it's not easy. Best in show. Are you guys, or best group? Oh, best group. Oh, I missed, okay. Just kidding. Best group. This performance was really, really, really good. A lot of the people, I feel like, especially for going first on stage, they did a really good job. And it goes to the Dollhouse singing group. Surprise, there's one more award. And it's my award! The con chair spotlight that I chose goes to Anna and Elsa because I really, really want to build a snowman with them. Brittany, so predictable. All right, now, best in show. They did a really, really good job choreographing this whole thing. And it takes really a lot of skill to make everything nice and on time. It's gonna be the Avatar group. They did a really good job dancing, fight scene and everything was really awesome. Totally in character and everything. Good job, good job. Everybody give another round of hand applause, whatever how you say it.